Okay, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. First of all, I wish to thank Bonn University for inviting me. My name is Holger Finken. I'm head of section research fellowship programs at the German Academic Exchange Service, the EED. And I'm going to talk about the PRIME concept, which is a new concept for postdoctoral funding with the EED. A PRIME deciphers like postdoctoral researchers' international mobility experience. So some words about the DAD. Are some of you funded by the DAD? Yeah? Okay, quite a few. Yeah, good to see, thank you. DAD was founded in 1925 as a grassroots initiative by law students, but then of course developed into a more or less government financed NGO nowadays. We have a budget of about 500 million per year at the moment. Most of these funds come from the federal government of Germany. Part of it comes from the European Union because we are the national agency of the European Union for the higher education programs. 18% in 2015 came from the European Union. And we have a couple of other sources which are mainly foreign governments, which with whom we have matching funds programs. So over the years, we started when we were refounded after the war in 1950 with more or less zero Deutschmarks, and we have, as I said, something like half a billion of euro at the moment. We are, as somebody has mentioned today, the biggest mobility organization, higher education worldwide. In 2015, we funded mobility for 75,000 Germans who went out to see the world, and we funded 51,000 foreigners who came to see Germany, academics, of course, students, researchers, and artists. So we have a big worldwide network of regional offices and information centers. And this was just the introduction. Now about postdoc funding with the DAD. You have this chart here with four cases. You're either an international postdoc or a German postdoc, and you want to go either abroad or to Germany. So far, we had different programs for Germans who wanted to go abroad, and also one small program for Germans who wanted to come back from abroad. And we had programs for foreign postdocs who wanted to come to Germany. Of course, we did not have and do not have programs for foreigners who wanted to go abroad with German money. But we recently have invented PRIME as a new program, and this gives you all these possibilities, as I will show in a couple of minutes. With regard to who counts as a German and who counts as a foreigner in this context, this may be interesting to quite a few of those present. There is a rule in the EED, which is rather new, that under certain conditions, a foreign academic in Germany can be counted as a German and can apply for the programs that are open to Germans only. And the conditions are, you would have to be enrolled at a German university in a degree program, or you would have to do a PhD at the German university. You know that for this you do not necessarily have to be enrolled in Germany, so doing a PhD at a German university would be the second possibility. And in both these cases, of course, the EED is free to decide whether to count you as a German or not. And the important thing and the important basis for such a decision is that you that there is a good expectation and a well-founded expectation that you will come back to Germany after being funded by the DAD for studying or doing research abroad. So some of the German programs are open to foreigners too under these conditions. So, but let us come to PRIME. PRIME is, as I said, a new program. It is somewhat similar to what Philipp Tillen just introduced, the Eigene Stelle or Temporary Positions Program at DFG, because what we offer there are no longer scholarships in the old sense, but as in Eigene Stelle Program of DFG, temporary job contracts or temporary positions. The PRIME scheme provides for a combination of outgoing and incoming phases. So you would have a 12-month outgoing phase and a 6-month incoming phase, a reintegration phase to Germany. Then funding would be different from what you experienced so far. You would no longer get a grant or a scholarship from DAD, but you will be paid because you have a temporary job contract with a German university, and the DAD will fund your university salary through a grant agreement between the DAD and the employing German university. Prime is, as you see at the very top of this transparency, funded jointly by the Federal Ministry of Education and Research of Germany and by the European Union. European Union funds the Prime scheme through the same scheme that we have heard about, that is Marie Curie Co-Fund, still in the old seventh framework program, but in the future we hope that we will get funding from the European Union through Horizon 2020 as well. Now, what is very interesting with Prime is, of course, the conditions, because Prime is, even without any of those conditions I just talked about, open to all nationalities, and it is by definition open to all disciplines, and it's open to all destinations, except for the foreign phase, Germany. But of course, in the second phase, in the reintegration phase, you will go to Germany with the Prime funding as well. And there are no age restrictions. So the scheme works like that. You would have an 18-month work contract at a German university. The contract would cover a mobility phase during which you would be abroad of 12 months and an reintegration phase to Germany, or an integration phase to Germany if the applicant is a foreigner, of 6 months. If the applicant is a foreigner who has never been to Germany before and has never had any contacts with the German social security system, then in some cases we have also an alternative funding cycle which would consist in one month in Germany to get entitled to German social security payments, 12 months abroad, and just 5 months of reintegration in Germany afterwards. The funding would be a salary according to the public sector pay scale, TBL 13, same as what we heard from DFG a couple of minutes ago. And plus you would get an expatriate allowance, which is quite considerable, and would depend on your country of destination. And the only payment you would get directly from DAD is a travel allowance to your destination and back to Germany. The success rate in Prime is 16%, so it's a highly competitive program. What are selection criteria in Prime? Academic qualification, of course, the grades, study duration, letters of recommendation, and so on. We are talking about a postdoctoral program, so publications would be highly important. Number of publications, quality of publications, impact factor, first authorships, and all those things that you know are highly important in such a contest. Then the project, of course, would be the core of any application, as in all programs, and there the scientific quality would play the major role, but also realistic planning and feasibility. Then the suitability of the host institutions would play a very important role, because we are talking about postdoctoral studies again, and these are highly specific, and usually there are, well, between 3 and maybe 15 suitable first-class labs all over the world, and if you want to be successful in Prime, then you would have to be able to identify the important labs and the first-class labs for the project you want to do. And if you can't identify them, then you will not be successful with your application in Prime. And on top of all these core components, there might be other achievements that would count, like extracurricular activities, social commitment, previous transnational mobility, personal circumstances. So, for instance, unavoidable delays in academic development due to childcare could be taken into account, as in many other programs as well. The selection process in Prime works as follows. First, the applications would be reviewed by external experts, usually two or more. In 2016, in the third round, we had 205 applications, and 179 of those entered the review process. The other ones were rejected for formal reasons. Then there is a selection committee meeting. In 2016, we had 24 professors. It's a postdoctoral program, so you have to be rather specific. And they came from six countries. There's a requirement from the European Union that the selection committee contains at least one-third of professors who come not from Germany. The selection committee meeting produces a final ranking, and after that, the results are communicated to the applicants. They get either approval or rejection letters, and they also get anonymized reviewers' comments. So what were the results so far? Between 2014 and 2016, which was the pilot phase of PRIME, we identified 85 fellows, 30 in the first year, 25 in the second year, and again 30 in the third year, 2016. And the distribution according to subject areas you have in this chart here, and you have a rather even distribution between humanities and social sciences on the one hand, life sciences, natural sciences, and a very small fraction of engineers as well. What is the breakdown by nationality, or what was the breakdown of nationality over the years? We had a percentage of, difficult to read here. Yeah, you can read it better than me. So a percentage over 60% of Germans. So the non-German component is rather big, as you can see. And you have quite a few countries that were successful in this competition. We had four posts, three people from the United Kingdom, three from Italy, two from Spain, two from Greece, two from the US, two from China, and a couple more, one each from each country. And where did they go? Well, maybe not so surprising, the biggest country of destination is the United States. And then we have also the UK, which is, again, usually the country, the second country of destination for postdocs. And then you have countries like Austria, Canada, Australia, Belgium, Switzerland, and so on. So you see the number of destination countries also rather big. On the other hand, you have distribution which is rather similar to all the postdoc programs, because the biggest number of people wants to go to the United States or UK, usually. And finally, the program has, of course, the objective of creating professors at German universities. Whether these professors are German or non-German is immaterial in this context. And so far, we have six people from PRIME, from the first cohort, who have been called as junior professors, or in one case as a W1 professor. And there's one more who has been called as head of an Eminöter group recently. So seven of the 30 people from the first cohort have made it so far, and we are confident that there will be many more. So I think I don't have any time anymore. So thank you very much for your attention. So these are my contact data, and I will be here like Philip Thelen to the end of the coffee break, and you can ask me your questions. Thank you very much again.